I need a full frame camera. Get me a full frame camera. Yes, I have a full frame camera. Yes.
Do you know this camera? I bet you don't. This is Panasonic DMZ200. It's basically a toy camera with a Leica lens. And this is the photos I've taken with that camera. What is full frame camera? Now, full frame camera, pretty simple, big sensor, very good low light. They're definitely expensive. They have got good video, good dynamic range, and so on and so forth. APS-C, it's more like a smaller sensor lens camera. Can be very cheap, affordable, smaller. And Micro Four Third, it's even smaller, basically half of the size of full frame camera. So that means physically, they're really, really small. Ergonomics is very good. They got a very good e-bike, very good video. APS-C is basically the best of both worlds. You can say that easily. Now, they all got good video because nobody buys a camera today without a video capability. Doesn't matter if you need the video or not, but you have to have that video capability. If you want to have a good video and a full frame camera, this is going to cost you a lot of money. I'm pretty sure you know that, but trust me if you don't know, that is going to cost you a lot of money, where APS-C and Micro Four Third cost significantly less, and indie filmmakers actually use those cameras day-to-day basis for their commercial production. Why I'm talking about this? Because I think there's going to be a time where there's not going to be any much difference between a full frame APS-C and a Micro Four Third, given the technology. Remember, medium format used to be the king of photography one day. Because yes, that's true, though there are a lot of mirrorless full frame camera exist, they're significantly small. Problem with those that the lenses are still huge. You cannot defeat physics. So you're gonna have like this tiny little camera, full frame, with these gigantic bigger lenses, which is not a problem with the Micro Four Third and APS-C. And personally, I don't always shoot raw, and I don't stack 30 photos together to get the best dynamic range and noise-free photos. That's your jam, not mine. Just remember, 99% of the world population today are really happy with their smartphone cameras, and they're really good, trust me. Because we keep forgetting that it's not the camera that takes good photo, it's you who take a very good photo. Look at the software ranges. You have Topaz, you have the Luminar AI. So that means that doesn't matter what camera you use, if you have a good software, it can replace the Sky to something else. It can make a Disneyland out of it. Don't tell me that you don't use those software. Now let's move on to some technical examples. Now, I've got some notes that I've taken from the website so that I don't Both Canon RF and Olympus Micro Four Third. I would choose lens Olympus 150 and 400mm f4.5 TC1.2X teleconverter, cost about 7,000, over the Canon RF 100 to 500mm f4.5 to f7.1, cost about 3,000 any day. It's very simple. At 1,000mm, the Canon RF becomes f14.2. with the teleconverter. At 1000mm, the Olympus becomes f5.6, aka f11 full frame equivalent, with the integrated teleconverter. And Olympus has better stabilization. If you use Canon R5, the diffraction starts at f8. So the imagine the soft result at f14. With the Olympus, the diffraction starts at f6.3, which is in full frame f11. At 1000mm, which is f5.6, f11, so you are below the diffraction limits. Of course, Olympus combination is more expensive, but gives a lot better result. This is not a full frame camera. Now, if you look at the photography forum, every single camera brands are a mistake. You cannot dance because the floor is not flat enough. Be careful. Don't let these dotard YouTubers sponsored by Squarespace and Storyblocks telling you which one is good and which one is bad. The good photographers don't always stay in YouTube. They actually got things to do other than making videos about telling you how good they are. Remember, they're just YouTubers. They're not physics experts. They're not actual photographers. They probably have a lot of followers on Instagram and YouTube. Doesn't make them a good photographer. If your photos suck, take a good look at your own photography skill, because your photos will be as good as your confidence and your basic knowledge on photography, because chances are, if your photos suck, that means there's something wrong with your photography and it's as good as my dancing skill. It's a disaster.